Welcome to the Coral Classroom. In the last 30 years, over 50% of coral reefs have died. Though corals have existed for more than 400 million years, ongoing stressors degrade reefs faster than they can adapt to changing conditions. Let's learn more about the threats our coral reefs are facing. Since the Industrial Revolution, atmospheric carbon dioxide concentrations have been increasing, causing more absorption into the ocean. This has changed seawater chemistry, causing roughly a 30% increase in the ocean's acidity. Ocean acidification inhibits calcifying organisms like corals from building their shells and skeletons. Corals grow slower and build thinner skeletons, leaving them vulnerable to wave damage and predators. Due to global warming, ocean temperatures have exceeded the threshold corals and their symbiotic algae can withstand. Under this stress, corals expel the algae from their tissue and lose their color, known as bleaching. Bleached corals lose a vital energy source and will likely die if conditions do not subside. Stony coral tissue loss disease is an infectious pathogen first reported in 2014 and causes tissue death in stony corals. It manifests as white lesions spreading across the colony. This disease is extremely deadly, killing corals within weeks or months. It rapidly spread along Florida's coral reef, affecting nearly 90% before crossing into the Caribbean. There are many sources of land-based pollution that degrade the ocean's water quality. This pollution carries nutrients, toxins, and bacteria that harm coral, stimulate algae overgrowth, and increase chances of disease and bleaching. It also turns up sediments, reducing sunlight and decreasing corals' ability to feed, grow, and reproduce. Of the coral reefs that remain, 75% are threatened by stressful conditions. It is imperative that we work to save our corals by reducing the global and local stressors they are facing.